Hello there, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to another reaction video. It's release day for Dream Theater's new single, From a View from the Top of the World, called Invisible Monster. And to be honest, this artwork looks amazing. I'm super hyped about it. And it brings back memories, you know. I see images and words with the spider in the window, and I see Awake. I see a lot of good stuff here, and I'm super hyped for this. Because it's an honor, you know. Dream Theater is my favorite band, and to be able to record a reaction video for them and for their songs is just, it's something new. And it's very nice for me to look back, like, down the road in 10 years or something, that I'm like, oh yes, you remember the first time you heard the Invisible Monster, and I could just watch it back then, you know, and just experience like it's the first time. I'm super hyped, my friends. I absolutely love this band, and I cannot wait to dive into this. So here we go. Without further ado, make sure to hit that subscribe button if you like it. Also, thumbs up, comment in the section below, and make sure to hit subscribe button on Dream Theater's official YouTube page as well. I will post a link in the description. Make sure to do that, because there's been a trend where people often just watch reactors versions and not the original one, and I think it matters that you go there, drop a comment, leave a like, and without further ado, let's go. Dream Theater, Invisible Monster. I can't wait, my friends. Here we go. Nice effects. Okay, before we continue, that intro, that effect on the drum kit, that was pretty dope. I don't think I've ever heard that before. We're just rocking, we're just jamming in 4/4 here, and it sounds like a single I expected instead of the Alien so far, you know, like just a regular poppy beat, just 4/4, nothing crazy going on yet. But yeah, we're not even 1 minute into the song yet, so we get the crazy stuff. Let's continue, friends. Yes. Okay, I believe that was the first one, and to be honest, there is this thing in the intro I forgot to mention, I really like, and they use it a lot. It's that sharp 11 there. It's so amazing. I always love when they use that sharp 11, and you heard that in the Alien as well. It's always, I love that chord, you know, it's always dope. Aside from that, we are jamming in 7/4 right here. It's pretty dope. Just basic riffage with enough of room for James to pop through. It's in the lower registers, which I think is pretty good for James. We're gonna dive into the chorus right here, see what is going to happen. So far, so good. I really like that driving riff, playing that bass tone sounds so good, ladies and gentlemen. I always like when the bass pops through as well, you know. So far, so good. Quality is outstanding. From the flame, the choice to seek or hide is yours to make.
La serpentine inside, wrapping its tail.
what a chorus. That just goes everywhere. That chorus is not in a specific key. It's just popping through, making use of all different kinds of modes, or what do I even say? Making use of all kinds of different chords, schematics, so to speak, and it's a banger. It's a safe song for James, and it's not even bothering me. It's pretty good. It's pretty good. I'm happy with this. Great melody here, but that second verse, that was pretty dope. We hear Mangini jamming in 7/4 or in 4/4, just continuing that afterbeat, while the other bandmates are just playing some staccato riffs. I dig it a lot, and that chorus is pretty dope. It's not extremely amazing chorus in my opinion, but it's catchy, you know. It does the job. It is it changes key constantly, and I dig that, using chords from different keys, and that is just, they do that a lot. Jordan writes a lot like that, and I just love that. It's so refreshing. I think this is a very refreshing Dream Theater song, and so far it doesn't remind me of anything at all yet, you know. So yeah, maybe you disagree. If you disagree, please let me know what it reminds you of, and in the comment section below, because I'm curious, you know. Let's continue. We have like a little break here. Oh. That was it. Oh, I feel this transitions into the next song. That ending. What a... So, okay, I'm gonna try to put to words what I think about it. It feels like it's a very good single, you know? It's unlike The Alien, which was for the Dream Theater lover, this is for the Dream Theater lover as well. But more poppy, more to mainstream public. We had a little talk about that last time with the Alien, where someone said they broke that thing where they just release a single for the broader audience, so to speak. And this is a song that will speak to a bigger audience than the Alien. I'm 100% sure. This is much more approachable. Mike Mangini is not doing extremely crazy stuff right here. The band is just pretty chill. Beautiful melodies, I'm not gonna lie. The chord progressions are out of this world. I love the way they transitioned from that solo to the chorus again. And I might have expected another keyboard solo there, but then again, we're here at a 6 minute 30 seconds song. And it's good, you know? It's just very good. I don't have the same vibes I had with The Alien, because that just totally blew me away. But this is a really enjoyable song, and I can imagine when I give it a couple of spins that I will really dig this song, because it's very approachable, because it's not too crazy. It's just like, put it on, enjoy it, you know, and it's all good. And we need those songs on an album as well. So yes, I'm super hyped about this. Ladies and gentlemen, this is such a blast so far to have The Alien first and now Invisible Monster. To be honest, I would have thought they will put out the 8-string song, because they announced the JP's 8-string signature as well. I figured, well, that might be the next single that we're going to hear. But that was not the case. I think this is just a 6-string. And again, my friends, I'm going to try to figure out what's being played here and hopefully be able to record another one-take cover. And I don't know if you've seen the one-take cover of The Alien. That was extremely hard to do, by the way, because it was like I listened to the song, I practiced the entire day and studied the song, and the day after I recorded it, and it was just... It took so much time, but it was such a blast as well. And I hope I'm able to do that for this song as well. Just have some fun, you know. It's nothing serious. It's just fun. And it's great practice for me. Because normally, I told you, I'm in a Dream Theater tribute band. So I study those songs and I have like the notes and the tabs. And I have a lot to figure out, but I can just read it, so to speak. And this time, because there are no tabs yet, I have to practice and study it by ear, which adds so much value in my practice session, to be honest. So it's absolutely a fun thing to do, to just kind of go and practice and study a song from the audio only. So yeah, ladies and gentlemen, I hope I'm able to put it out tomorrow or maybe even today. If I'm really fast, I don't think so. Maybe I think tomorrow will be a good day, or the day after tomorrow. I don't want to push myself too hard as well. But yeah, I'm gonna definitely try my best to figure something out. And I hope you enjoyed this, ladies and gentlemen. It was a fun ride. It was a great tune. I'm super excited for the album to drop. One more month. One more month. We're almost there. Yes. So yes, friends, if you like it, make sure to hit that subscribe button. Follow the channel for more Dream Theater updates and other bands. There are a lot of bands I react to and artists which are totally worth your time. And so yeah, make sure to check some of the other stuff out as well. It will mean a lot. Also, I hope to see you for next video, right? Thank you so much for watching. Have a great day, everyone. Much love. Take care. Cheers.